Hi friends of Spazio Rock, tonight we're here with Fiction Plane. Hello guys, welcome to Spazio Rock.
Thank you.
How is Sparks going? Is it well received by the audience and the press? And I must say I really appreciate that.
Well, we really appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you. I think it's going great. It's been fun being on tour and playing the songs that we wrote in a New York basement studio. And it's been great on tour playing them live for different audiences throughout Europe. So we're having a blast.
I agree. Let's see.
New York City is a very inspiring city, isn't it?
It is.
Now, be honest. Describe me a quality of Sparks and find me a flaw or something you would like to change or improve.
I think the main quality of it is that we created it from together, collaboratively, from improvisations, and it sort of has magic in a way that I don't think we understand how it happened. So that's pretty interesting. I don't know if I've got any flaws. Everything I'd do again if I could, but that's what we play live for. Every night we play it in another way.
Yeah, I haven't listened to it since we finished it that much. We hear it, when we go to record shops or stuff, but it's a little bit close to the time that we made it to criticize, but I'm sure I will criticize it soon. You always do every time you make a record.
This is a feature I'm always very curious about. Where did you take your inspiration for the lyrics of the album?
Various places. Sometimes it's just we were improvising the music and I would improvise the words just the same. I started off making just some noises, and then we record everything and listen back and you think, okay, that kind of sounds like these words. It's just like, and then you can hear like, oh, I'm just playing table football in there. But a lot of books as well, a couple of tracks, Master and Margarita, the Bulgakov book, just like directly stole things from there.
So this is a question for Joe. I know it's a very common question, but how does it feel like being Sting's son, since in the end you're doing the very same job?
Well, I think my job is different, because we have a different aim. I think we just want to make creative music and really enjoy it. We're not so directly like going for the peak of fame. Because it's not really that interesting.
Does it bother you when your music is compared to the Police?
Well, on one hand, yeah, it definitely does, because I think 9 times out of 10 when it's compared, without actually really listening to our music. It's just, it's a prejudgment. The 1 time out of 10 that it's not prejudging, if someone gives me a really genuine reason, I can hear the similarities to Joe, I can hear the similarities to Pete, and in some instances to me, there are a lot worse people to be compared to. They wrote some great songs.
They're not saying we sound like James Blunt, so...
No, James Blunt...
Fucking rock on!
Exactly, Christa Berg. I mean, The Killers to me sound like Christa Berg. The guy just sounds exactly like Christa Berg. It's Brandon Flowers, but I would much rather be compared to The Police than Christa Berg. So I'll take that.
So, what about your career? Have you always wanted to be a musician, or it just came out with the years?
Since I wanted to be a musician when I was 14, I wanted to be an artist, and I didn't have any concept of any other way of being a musician, I think.
Yeah, I'd agree. It's only sort of later in, through time that you understand, maybe there's other things in music like production or engineering or whatever. Production, I think, would be interesting maybe later down the line. It could be interesting, or it could actually be really tedious and quite frustrating. I don't really know.
You just tell the engineer to do what he does.
Yeah.
Do what you do. Make it sound good. And it was my idea.
As long as it's still artistic and creative, I think I'll be interested in it.
Yes.
Yeah. See? Don't ask a drummer that complicated question. No,
we all love being artists and musicians, but I think we hate being businessmen, which, it's not our strong suit.
Yeah,
I
agree with that.
You said that Nirvana and grunge were a big inspiration for you, but is there any other band or music genre that inspired you that much?
I think just it was the sort of visceral feeling of grunge that made me want to be in a band, and that's at age 14 or something, that's kind of when you decide I'm part of this exact gang. But everything else is interesting, you know, from like Frank Zappa to Wagner, it's all amazing.
So I used to be part of Kool in the Gang. That was my gang.
Sorry, was that just stupid?
Stupid.
Estúpido.
Stupido. Stupido.
How do you see fiction playing in 10 years?
Hopefully not dead.
Hopefully with this not that much less hair.
Yeah. Same amount of hair.
Mine will be gray, more gray. But.
Capello grigio.
I have white hair too.
No, we have it. We've got them, but like not too much of it. Actually, I'd rather have lots of white hair than no hair, so.
Is there any other band or artist you would like to tour with?
We get asked this quite often, and we think Muse would be a pretty amazing band to tour with right now. They put on an amazing show, and I think they're really cool, but they're not like really trendily cool for school. They've always sort of been on the fringe. And I'd say we're quite similar like that. I don't think we're like a real sort of trendy, like fashionista band. And I don't think we ever really want to be. And I like that and respect that about them. But at the same time, they're cool, you know, and they're great musicians and we all respect them. And that'd be a cool tour, I think.
And I know they've been dying to tour with us. So we're giving, we're going to go ahead and let them.
We'll see you there, Matt. Come on. Us,
you know, I'll tour with you. It's fine.
But people who listen to Muse as well. Hey, phone. Like the people who go to their shows are generally a kind of like just general rock fans. They're not specifically like metal Germanic sort of opera fans. They're like, it's become a more wide reaching thing. So that's interesting for us because we definitely
they've taken the audience of Queen.
Yeah, could be, and we'd like to take it from them.
What do you think of Italy? What are your thoughts about our country?
I love Italy. The countryside, the food, the people are very sweet, and the traffic is insane. You guys know how to drive, but other than that, I love it.
I don't like driving in Italy at all. No. Not at all. But apart from that, I've enjoyed all my experiences in Italy very much. Okay. It's beautiful, so much culture, food, it's, you know.
You know, someone said that in Milan, there are very bad drivers.
I thought that Naples said they were the worst.
So thank you very much for your time for this interview. And now would you like to say something to our Spazio Rock users and your fans? Please look at the camera.
Hey everybody, we're Fiction Plane. We're in Milan. Please come to our show so we can come back like every year.
Andiamo.
Spacca tutto.